Have you guys heard about Cascadeur? It was a little bit of a new experience for me. I like to be in complete control and I had to let go of the reins a little bit since it uses AI assisted animation and automatic physics and secondary motion. But I am also a huge fan of efficiency and this is meant to really speed up your workflow and increase your efficiency, so I had to check it out for myself. I'd love to hear in the comments if anyone else has used it and what you thought about it. But in the meantime, here's my experience and if I think it genuinely will help with 3D animation.
So it looks pretty cool. It actually started as an internal animation tool for Nike, a games publisher, and they recently made it public. You can use it to pose your characters with the rest of the body automatically moving into a natural position as you do it and animate with automatic physics and secondary motion. So you should, in theory, be able to do pretty complex animations really quickly. I can see this being super useful, especially for game animators with all their action sequences and loops, if it is as cool and easy to use as it claims and as all the other videos I've seen about it claim. One of the things I like most about it is that the logo seems to be a simplified wireframe cat head, and anything to do with cats is a-okay by me. Anyway, let's be serious. To start off with, you need a model with a rig to animate with. So I generated a 3D model with an armature very quickly and for free with Ready Player Me, downloaded the FBX and imported that into Cascadeur with zero issues. I must note that it seems to only import FBX or Collada files. You can also use these default models that it comes with. So when you import your model, you'll get this pop-up asking if you want to enter rig mode to rig the model so that it can actually be used in Cascadeur. So of course I say hell yeah. For humanoid characters, it's best to use the quick rigging tool, but you can rig in anime characters that are not humanoid, so let that allay your fears in that respect. So I'm going to click OK here, where it's giving me another helpful tip to click on Add Rig Elements, since my character was successfully recognized since it used a rig that Cascadeur recognizes the setup and hierarchy of, and you can see it's placed joints at the correct places. There is a certain degree of editability here where you can remove or add joints as well, or change which joints are allocated to a spot, but I don't need to change anything, so I'm going to just say OK. In the case where you use a rig where Cascadeur doesn't recognize it, like say you used a Rigify rig or something, you'll have to do this manually, dragging the bones or joints across to here since it won't recognize the rig automatically. If you are trying to use a complex custom rig, like a Rigify rig, which I did test out, there are a few extra steps you'll need to take to first simplify your rig and basically make it like a game engine rig. And to do that, I used a really useful Blender add-on called Game Rig Tools, which I'll link to in the description. Then you bring that rigged model as an FBX into Cascadeur, re-rig it with the quick rigging tool, then carry on as you would, animate it, then when you bring it back into Blender, you can retarget the animation to your Rigify rig. Then you can have a control rig that you can still adjust the animation on in Blender after retargeting. I found a video from a creator named Aron Nemeth who actually has a lot of really useful content about Cascadeur and getting it to work for you, particularly with Blender, and he has a tutorial on using a Rigify rig. He manually simplified the rig in Blender first, so he didn't use the Game Rig Tools add-on like I did when I was trying it out, but the rest of the process is the same, so check that out if you want. I'll link to that video in my description. So anyway, with this basic rig, I now have it in here, and check this shit out. I can move it around, it's rigged, and when I pose her, you can see with AI assistance, it moves the rest of the body and tries to predict a realistic pose. If I move her on back, it swivels the rest of the body, the upper body more than the hips, because that's how body mechanics naturally work. If I undo this and now lift her leg, her center of mass shifts to the other leg and her arms go up as they would in real life to maintain her balance. So this all looks pretty dope, you know? This should make the life of a 3D animator much easier. When I did this little test where she jumps from one leg to the other, it was cool, and after adding the physics and secondary motion, it was even better. It's really nice not to have to worry about that and have it automatically done for you, and you can tweak the severity of the effects really easily. I ended up having a pretty nice little animation loop with not very much effort at all. Obviously, I could have spent a little more time tweaking things, but I was impatient to try out some other things and see how it did with something a little more complex. So I did what most animators hate, the walk cycle. Maybe it's just me, but walk cycles? Not my fave. So you'll see here, while this is assisted animation, where the body responds to what you're doing with the rest of it and it tries to predict what you're trying to do with the pose, you still need to lay down the key poses yourself. You still need to have some knowledge of how to animate, and it doesn't do the timing for you either. So key poses, timing, spacing, that's still up to you. If you're somebody who does not have the foggiest idea how to animate, this app is not a magical panacea that's gonna do it for you. But I like that, because if it did, well, I'd be out of a job. So I'm glad I still have my uses. And it's really cool that this just gives us some help along the way, but it's still up to you to give it a base to work off of and adjust what's looking whack. Once I applied the physics to the walk cycle, you can see it still needed adjusting, but after a few tweaks, I got a passable walk cycle in quite a short amount of time. Obviously, I could have spent more time perfecting it. There are still some issues, and I had some struggles, particularly with the arms and the automatic adjustments that the rig wanted to make when I did stuff to the arms. But for the amount of time I spent on this, it's pretty okay. I tried some other stuff with my own model that I quickly rigged with Mixamo. I'm not actually done with making this model yet, but I just wanted to try it out with my own character. Obviously, it's not perfect. There were some issues, particularly with the arms again, but there are a lot of handy tools here that you can use to tweak and finesse, like seeing the trajectories and being able to edit them. And there's a tween machine, which if you've ever used tween machine in Maya, you'll know how helpful that can be. There's even video mocap where you can import a reference video and it'll take the poses from that and apply the poses from that reference to your model. This is a new feature that they only recently added, I think in like May, but when I tried it out, it wasn't too bad. And obviously it depends on the quality of the reference video and how clear the poses are and stuff. You can still adjust it after it's done processing. I have to say, Cascadeur is awesome, but it does have a bit of a learning curve to understand how things work, and some things are a little frustrating when you're new to it. At first, it'll take you quite a while to animate things as you get the hang of how everything works, and at times it kind of feels like you're fighting against what the AI is trying to do in some cases. And the whole poses assistance thing can actually be a bit difficult to manage when you're trying to do something really specific. But I'm sure these issues also get less the more used to the program you get, because obviously while I've animated some stuff in here, I'm by no means a pro or super experienced with it yet, so those are just my observations as someone who's quite new to the program. It would be awesome if it supported facial rigs. Unfortunately, it doesn't yet, but that does seem to be in the pipeline. And I also hope that at some point they'll make it easier to use with other types of rigs, as well as to support audio, because sometimes you gotta animate to audio, right? Apparently, that is something they're working on for the next version. Otherwise, it's a really great piece of software, and it genuinely does help to speed up workflow and make some parts of animating a bit easier. It's like having your own little junior assistant doing your interpolation and in-betweens for you. It's got most of the things you'd need to be able to create nice animations. You can import reference videos, there are ghosting tools, different types of interpolation, you can change between FK and IK while you're animating, there's this cool thingy that shows you the center of mass, which is also really helpful, and that's just scratching the surface. There is so much more to this program than I would be able to cover in just this video.
Give the video a like if you found it useful and informative, subscribe if you want to keep up to date with my other videos, and let me know in the comments if this is something that you think you could use in your pipeline, or if it's something you've used before and what you thought about it. Thank you so much to my patrons for your support and the chats. I really appreciate you guys. Okay, bye!